Street Edition. Which is the least crazy sounding food to eat? Bananas?
Yeah.
Doesn't bananas sound crazy? Someone's bananas are crazy. Crazy based question, great for Floridians. You're crazy if you think nuts isn't crazy.
Bacon?
Why?
Everybody loves bacon.
Your bananas means you're crazy.
And nuts.
You're nuts.
And you're nuts.
No one ever says you're bacon.
That's a pretty cheesy joke, though.
That's insulting. Which
continent below do the most... All right, our next guest has been named by TBS as one of the funniest comedians working today.
That's right. Ben Glib, host of Game Show Network's Idiot Test and regular on shows such as Kathy Lee and Hoda, Comedy Central and E, and his new tour has kicked off, which included a stop here in Tampa, and now he is stopping by our show. Welcome, Ben. How are you?
I'm really good. Thank you for having me. I had such a fun time playing Side Splitters, I decided to come here and promote it after the weekend was done.
I love that. I love that. That just means you're promoting the next stop, because there's got to be another one, right?
I'll be back. I will be back.
Yeah, I almost didn't recognize you, by the way.
Thank you. I grow a beard whenever I'm not shooting my show, Idiot Test, which is stupid, because then people don't recognize me. They don't come to my shows. It's a mistake. I have a podcast, and so it's mostly auditory, and I don't care about how I look. And then I come here, and you ladies look nice, and I feel stupid.
Well, not at all. I say we don't want to feel stupid around you, given the show that you host is called Idiot Test.
True.
But you brought up the podcast first, so let's go there. Right now is such an interesting time with what's going on culturally speaking. And to be able to have a podcast, that's your focus, right? So is it jokes just kind of write themselves, or what's your...
Yeah, it's very easy. This is to parody the world these days. You just have to repeat what's happening and then just make a face. Be like, really? Emojis really cover the emotion you need, which doesn't work well in audio form. But yeah, my podcast is called Last Week on Earth because we cover everything that happened during the last week. And it seems every week it's just more and more insanity. It's so much. There's too much fodder. It's like, if things would slow down, it would be great.
I like
that take. Let's talk about Idiot Test. It's such an interesting concept. Has it changed the way maybe you look at things? Because, I mean, you watch and it's changing our perspective when you look at how things are worded and how things are done. Has it changed you?
It has. It has changed my brain. It's made me smarter. I realized that I can't be dumb anymore when I got hired to host this show. And then I started helping write all the tests. So I help write every single test. I work on them all with our great staff of writers. And so I just try to look at everything now from a different perspective and figure out how the bigger picture might be different than when you get lost in the details. Sometimes you miss the grander message. And I think that's a lot of what we're doing in life in general. We're getting lost so much in every detail. We just lose sight sometimes of our values or who we are, what we want. So in that way it has. And I have just effectively made my game show sound a lot more important than it is.
That was nice. Fairly philosophical. I like that. And
thank you.
Talking about kind of the hands-off approach, how are you able to be hands-off? Because you have a ton going on. Mm-hmm. You're touring. You've got the game show. I mean, you're a guest, regular guest, on many of the shows that we listed at the top of this. Mm-hmm. How are you able to juggle everything like that? Because it's different roles for you as a comedian.
It is. And then I also have my Showtime special, and I'm also managing my own social media and posting things every day and Instagram
stories. Do you handle your own social media? Is that all you do?
I do. I post everything myself. I was posting stuff right now as I was sitting here. I'm addicted to it. You know, you're a one-man corporation these days to be a comedian, so it's a lot of work. And, drugs is the way you keep focus. I'm talking about legal drugs, which have worse side effects. So I don't know why that's better.
Right?
But we have a confusing system in our planet these days.
Hey, you're going deep.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about Florida real quick, because this is this attempt number three to get you in our show? We've had some cancellations, some crazy weather.
Florida, again,
setting the stage for a crazy life.
Well, Florida is an interesting state. You guys know that. Uh-huh. You live here. Every time on my podcast I'm reporting a story of something strange that happens, it's without fail in Florida. So hats off to you guys for mixing it up and keeping us on our toes as a nation. I feel like sometimes the strangeness drains into Florida.
We've heard that once or twice.
You've heard that? That's the way I feel. But I was going to come here last time to Side Splitters, and then right before, 2 days before, Irma came.
Uh-huh.
And so they canceled it because they didn't want me to die and all the people coming to the show to die. And I think that's a smart strategy.
It's incredible, we try.
Comedy's important, but not as important as non-dying. That's one of my strong rules.
Again, deep with this interview,
getting
Ben.
Super deep, yeah. But what is deep?
Ooh.
Oh, there's
Idiot
that. There's
how do
there.
I do it? I don't know how I get so in depth.
What are you most looking forward to in 2018? You got so much going on. What do you think you're, is there a particular, do you get a vacation at all?
I don't take a lot of vacations. I work pretty consistently through. I'm looking forward to the world not ending.
Okay.
And I
not being the last week.
Yeah, not all of us being sucked up into a huge sinkhole.
Okay.
Other than
There's
that,
sinkholes
I'm
here
good.
In Florida.
There are.
They're
oh, I know.
Right now.
I know. You throw some bath salts in there, and you got a nice little Florida stew. Is there anything else in this paper that we haven't touched on yet?
Oh, I like it. Look at this.
What else we got?
See, you can tell the game show host mentality is coming out. He's checking our to-do list.
I made comedy history by being the first comedian ever to live stream on Facebook Live. Thank you for mentioning.
Did you really?
I did. Yep.
All right. Oh, we didn't look at our notes very good.
I was gonna say, making history, producing our show. This guy is everywhere. Please come back.
It's been a pleasure being here.
Be a TV host with us. You can help co-host our show.
I would love to come in and co-host one time. Okay. I'd love that.
All right, sounds good.
I'll
love it too.
I'll dress nicer.
You look good.
Thank you, but like this isn't very morning. I'll get rid of the bad boy jacket and I'll put on a sport coat. I'll shave.
Okay. Good
I'll
plan.
Look presentable.
Good plan.
We'll drink maybe together, Hoda style.